In this short video on harmonic balance simulation, I'll cover how to set up the simulation controller and also some of the most commonly used sources for harmonic balance. I'll show you a power sweep and also another form of harmonic balance done strictly for compression testing called XDB. I'll show you the data, typically the spectrum, and how to plot it, and I'll give you a few important tips on doing harmonic balance simulation. Here in the examples directory, I've selected the microwave circuits folder and the large signal amp project. This particular project has both the harmonic balance one-tone analysis that you can see here and the swept power for harmonic balance, and those are the two that we'll be looking at. Let's go ahead and start with the first one, which is the one-tone harmonic balance design. So here's our first example, and harmonic balance gives you the spectrum and the amplitude. So what we have is a power source that's feeding into an amplifier that has a bias here. It has two wire labels or node names, and simply by clicking here and then typing in VIN, picking a wire, and VOUT, you get these labels, and that way you can look at the spectrum at both of these points. So because harmonic balance gives us the spectrum and the amplitude, we want to set it up to calculate what we expect to be inserted into the circuit, and then a number of harmonics which will account for the nonlinearities of our device or our amplifier. And that's what's done here. Let's quickly look at this amplifier. I'll push into it using this hierarchical push into, and notice there's a device and a lot of microstrip elements. You can see it's quite crowded. So zooming in, you can see that these microstrip elements refer to a substrate FR4. Let's pop back out, and that's this M sub, and that's defining all of the substrate as FR4, so that's the name of it. So that's what's in this example, a harmonic balance controller set to 1 gigahertz with order equals 7. That means a total of 7 harmonics. So that's the fundamental and 6 harmonics, and it will calculate those and give you the spectrum at the input and the output. Before we look at the results, I'm going to scroll down and insert a brand new harmonic balance controller from the palette. And when I do, the dialog opens, and we want to cover this briefly. Notice that it comes in a default condition showing 1 gigahertz order 3. So again, if we look at the dialog, this is where we can change that. Increase the order, change the frequency, and simply add it or cut and paste other fundamental tones and harmonics to this list. So again, you have a fundamental tone, freak, and then order, and the order is the total number of harmonics. Here, maximum mixing order, this is used when you calculate intermod products. So if you had a mixer, then you'd be using this. And once you have two tones, then you get intermod products, but because we only have one tone, it's grayed out. Status level refers to the information that is written to the status window, and that's true for all simulation controllers. In the next tab, sweep, this is ready to sweep a parameter. Now we'll look at the other example that sweeps RF power, and that would be normally typed in here if it's set up as a variable. And to set up variables in ADS, you simply select this variable block, insert it, and then declare a variable. These other tabs for initial guess and oscillator and small signal we're not going to cover here because we're only covering the basics, and these are typically used only in certain situations. Initial guess is for circuits that don't converge, but that's rare, and oscillator is for doing oscillator analysis with either a node specified or this os port. For noise, you can get nonlinear noise by simply turning on this checkbox and then going to these other two buttons, and they will open up giving you these selections. Harmonic balance also allows you to use these noise controllers, so if you click this and you were to insert a noise controller, such as this one here, then you're really setting up noise separately, and then you would be able to get it from the list, and there it is. That's how you do that, and the purpose of doing that is to have a separate noise simulation that you can turn on or off that is deactivated or activated easily for various frequencies. The Parameters tab can give you, for devices, the DC values, the operating point, either detailed or brief. And if you were to turn that on, you'd simply go to the Simulate detailed or brief icons and commands that you see there, and then you get that information. And here, the Output tab is where you can select specific node voltages or currents or measurement equations. Again, if you leave this in the default condition, you'll get everything that's on the schematic. Or there's an Add Remove button down below. Simply use that to add or remove individual currents and voltages or measurement equations. Now the Display tab is like the other controllers, where you can select which parameters of the controller you want displayed. And so to review harmonic balance, most of the time, if you want to get the spectrum or the power, you'll be using the Frequency tab, and that's where you set up the frequency so that it matches the frequency of your source, and also the sweep, whether you're sweeping power or anything else, that would just be a variable. Here, back at our design, I'm showing the simulation palette for harmonic balance. The controller's in the left corner, and it has the same options, parameter sweep, and sweep plan that all the other simulation palettes have. It also has several measurement equations that are used specifically for harmonic balance, and the OSPORT component in case you're doing oscillator analysis. Here, for example, is IP3 out. You insert this measurement equation, and then once you learn a little bit about harmonic balance data with a VOUT node that would have to be spelled the same way, so we can't have uppercase and lowercase, simply spell it the same way, and then you could get the IP3 out value, that's a third order intercept point for your circuit. So that's the palette, and the main thing is the controller. Now let's look at a few sources. With harmonic balance, we can go to the frequency domain, and here you can see the PN tone and the P1 tone. This is a P1 tone. So inserting it, it comes in just like this, and it has a function, polar function. Notice that's different than the dBm TOW, which is dBm to watts function. Because you can set the value in dBm, that's in these parentheses, and the phase, it has the polar function as a default. But most of the time, if you're only interested in having the value in dBm, you can insert your cursor, remove all the other information in the arguments, and simply set up the value like this in dBm. Now it's -10 dBm, and simply means dBm to watts for the simulator. Notice the frequency is set to 1 gigahertz. Again, you can set the frequency at anything you want. And if you have a simulation controller, you can use that frequency that will automatically override, and that's why this one's blank. So those are the basics of using the power sources for harmonic balance. Now let's look at the results for this simulation.